be supporting us too. Sure do. All right. Welcome everybody. This is the Old Meter Man coming back with you now for Blog Talk Radio live stream. And we want to say, first of all, I think Happy New Year is in order for the Bible study, because this is my first broadcast in the new year. In other words, I stopped on New Year's Eve night. We had to stop and we paused for the watch night service, so I wasn't able to have the Bible study on that particular Tuesday night. So we shut down for that. That was watch night. And so tonight is the first Tuesday of the new year in which I was able to do the broadcast. And so we just thank God for each and every one of y'all. And I think I already see my sister Lola done made it in. I see one watching, so I'm just going to assume that that's her. So we want to say that we are welcome everybody back to the Bible study. Business as usual. In fact, we have a lot of things going on already. We are just into the first week of the new decade and already been dealing with major issues already, having problems. That just to let y'all know that this in this life, we are not going to be without issues and problems. That is a given. You know, old Marvin Gaye told us years ago, three certainties, three things for sure in life: taxes, death, and trouble. Believe you me, we all have our share of it. So we just want to say also that we are already, like I said, just the first week into the new decade, and is already dealing with a whole bunch of some of it is nonsense, and all of it come from the Satan himself. As y'all know that right now our country, being a vet myself, I got a special soft spot for what's going on right now with the troops being deployed back over into the Middle East. In other words, people, I tell you, it was 30 years ago we started Desert Shield. That was back in 1990. That was in my era. And Desert Shield, and then it turned into Desert Storm. In other words, and that was over 30 years ago, and we right back at it again, right back in the same region. And I just want y'all to know that this is no surprise to God, and it ain't no surprise to Midi Man, because I know what God's word says. And I'm not the only one that know what God's word says. I'm just saying that I know what God's word says, and this is not no surprise, but nevertheless, let us all pray for our troops. Let us pray for our troops and pray for the nation that's going to be involved in this conflict, and which I do believe is going to be a conflict. But nevertheless, we got to go through with what we got to go through. It is what it is. And not only that, we got a lot of us got not only war on the foreign land, we got war right on our own land with different ones that we have to deal with the nonsense. And I tell you, it just like I say, y'all, don't complain too much about the devil, because see, the devil doing his job. The devil's never gonna quit until he be thrown in the lake of fire. That's gonna be when the devil will quit. In other words, God is gonna take care of the devil. So what we need to do is we need to just go on and put, like I said, Jesus whipped the devil at Calvary, and he gave us the stick. So now we set up here and let people that treat us in a kind of way, and let them keep letting the devil defeat us when he's a defeated foe, then we don't have good sense ourselves. And I just got to tell it like it is, people. If we sit around and let people manipulate us in a kind of way, and when you know when you are doing what is right, don't you get stand down for nobody. Don't stand down for nobody. And like I said, we are just about to get ready to go into the broadcast. In other words, like I told y'all, I do the broadcast over the phone line. And we will be getting ready to go on to it in about another 50 seconds. So y'all just stand by. I got a few things here that I want to get ready just before it started, the broadcast, and then we'll come right back broadcasting live streaming on YouTube as usual. And y'all thank God for the new year. We thank God for the new year, and we hope that y'all whole year be a great one. Not only this year, but the whole decade be great. So y'all please stand by. We will start in about maybe 20 seconds.
Your show will go live in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Log Talk Radio.
Here we go, people. Welcome to Block Talk Radio. Walk through the Word with the Minuteman. Good old-fashioned Bible study at its best. It is Minuteman prayer as always that the body of Christ be edified, Jesus Christ be glorified. As soon as my brother after the battle is finished with the new start, we're going to begin a brand new decade of the good old-fashioned Bible study. So please stand by. Everybody, Block Talk Radio, walk through the world with the Minuteman. God bless you, each and every one of you. Those of you that are joining us by way of the web, those of you that call in, those of you that are listening by way of YouTube in the live stream, we just want to say welcome and welcome back. We, like I said, Happy New Year, Happy New Decade is in order. We are thanking God for each and every one of you. The last Bible study we had was on Christmas Eve of 2019. And so, in other words, I had to watch night meeting on that following Tuesday. So I wasn't able to have the Bible study then. So, but lo and behold, thank God, to God be the glory, we are back tonight. And we just thanking each and every one of you for getting back on board with the Minuteman. Like I say, there are many have come and many have left. Old Minuteman throughout the years, but nevertheless, Minuteman is yet going strong with the Bible study. In other words, y'all, when God got his hands on something, you can't stop it. So you just going to do what you got to do. So we just thank God for all of y'all on this here Tuesday night of Bible study. And we're going to go ahead on, as there's no one in the lobby tonight. And let me also let y'all know, those of you that might be in the lobby of YouTube, it says, according to my computer, the live chat in YouTube is not available tonight. For whatever reason that might be, I don't know. They may be having technical difficulties. I believe it is, because I don't think there's nothing wrong with my PC this time. Because I got a yellow go, I got a yellow light and everything. The stream seemed to be doing good, but it does say that the live chat is unavailable. So if you type anything in the chat, well, matter of fact, you won't get it, because you shouldn't even get a chat box. So right here, we're going to go ahead on. Like I said, this is just a special broadcast of the Bible study tonight. Not going to be as normal, but we got a few things we want to just bring forth and let everybody know what's going on. And we're going to have a moment of prayer here, and then we're going to go ahead on and get into tonight's discussion. Heavenly Father, we come to you tonight in the name of Jesus, saying we thank you and we much obliged, Father God, for life, health, and strength. Thank you, Lord God, for being as well as it is, for bringing us all the way over through 2019 into the new decade. And we just say much obliged. Father God, we know it could have been the other way. For Father God, we could have been under the ground instead of on top of the ground. And we want to say thank you. And then, Lord God, we want to thank you for your son, Jesus, the one that died on Calvary, that I might have a right, that they might have a right, that all of us may have a right to the tree of life. And Father God, we just say thank you. And then, Lord, when we come down to the river of Jordan, we ask that you would shape your word as a vessel and fare our souls on a cross in the Beulah land, where we will rest, rule, and abide with thee forevermore. And let everybody say amen. We thank God for each and every one of you. Again, I say the chat is unavailable in YouTube tonight, so I won't be able to see anything that y'all post. But if you have anything that you want to ask Old Middle Man in any way, shape, form, or fashion, all you got to do is email me if you can. Email me at batmat@hotmail.com, and I'll definitely get back with you. If you got anything, if I say anything that you might not agree with, or whatever it might be, just correspond with me, and that way that you can always email me, and I will get that email. Want to say here tonight, my cyber friend, that we just thank God for as well as it is, and I'm quite sure that I want to get this out on top of the hour. I want to get this out that everybody knowing that our country is, might as well say, on the verge of another conflict. I remember over 30 years ago when I was involved, over 30 years ago to be exact, 30 years ago, I was involved. It was called Desert Shield at that time. We were getting ready to go to battle with Iraq, in other words, and that was in 1990. That was 30 years ago, people. Yes, right. 30. It don't seem like it that long, but it's been that long. And it went from Desert Shield to Desert Storm. And our troops are yet over there in the battle zone right now. And matter of fact, we had troops that were supposed to be deployed today or yesterday. We would say it now. It's getting late. To go on into Iraq. We had some of our 82nd Airborne out of Fort Bragg. Y'all, all of you vets, you know exactly who I'm talking about. Those are the Screaming Eagles. In other words, you know, that's airborne. And they got to do what they got to do. I'm just telling you, straight from the hip tonight, people. They got to do what they got to do. We praying for all the troops. But a soldier's job is to fight. That's our job. We fight. Nevertheless, we had some stuff that went on, and many men don't know all the parameters about this thing that went on. I don't know all the parameters about what went on with this here, the killing of this major general here of Iran. But let me say this first before I go any further, because I don't want anyone to think Mitty Man hating anybody, because I don't. I got some people that, some ways I don't like, but I don't hate nobody. But even the Iranians, those people, you can't hate those people. A lot of times people are up on the distress. A lot of times the innocent people always suffer and stuff like this, y'all. Let me just tell y'all that straight up. Because a lot of American citizens, they were spitting at our Vietnam vets when they came back home. Because they didn't understand what went on over there. They didn't have any way of knowing, and they prejudged folks. That's like coming to say you shouldn't judge anyway, because you, especially when you don't know what you're talking about. But they were spitting at our Vietnam vet because they were calling them baby killers and all that. But let me tell you something. There's something in the military called casualties of war. Some innocent people gonna get hurt. Some innocent gonna get killed. That it cannot be avoided. Now I'm not saying that everybody that get killed, in other words, in during a conflict, everybody love their loved one. We love our boys that going over there. Well, Iranians, I'm quite sure it's some Iranian soldiers that's in their military. They got some mom and dad that love them as well. So it's not who, in other words, let us pray. Pray for the benefit to both, in both scenarios, that God's will be done. And let me tell y'all something, people. Let me tell y'all something right now. God's will is being done. I know it may not seem like it, but God's will is being done. And if any of y'all have ever read the Bible and studied the Bible, I ain't there talking about reading the 23rd Psalm and maybe every now and then you read John 3:16. No, I'm talking about have you really studied the scripture? Study those prophecies and those everything that is going on right now is prophesied in the scriptures. It's in the Bible, people. It's in the Bible. Read Zechariah. Read Daniel. Read Isaiah. I mean, read Ezekiel. All of them. And if you don't want to go and read those, just go to Matthew 24 and read what Jesus said about these times that we are living in. Jesus spoke it very clearly and very plainly that perilous time was going to come. And y'all, we are in perilous time as I speak. We got soldiers in the air, perhaps, right now. We don't know. Like I said, we don't know exactly who the next deployed soldier is going to be. We don't know that. But we do know we already got soldiers in Iraq right now. We got military bases in Iraq because of the last war. But nevertheless, we need to pray for the soldiers that are involved in this conflict. And you hear what I say. We need to pray for the soldiers that are involved in this conflict, because guess what? I don't believe there's not one soldier that want to be in this conflict tonight. I don't believe it. Neither side. But you got some fanatics, and I realize that, y'all. I've been watching Iran for a long time. And for those of you that may not know that Iran, if I'm speaking, I'm not trying to insult no one's intelligence. Believe me now, I'm not trying to insult no one's intelligence, but I'm just going to tell you something that which I know because I have studied. Iran is what, let me tell y'all who Iran used to be. Persia. Read the scriptures. Ancient Persia. Do y'all remember a man named Haman? Y'all remember him, the one that tried to kill all the Jews during the time of Esther, when Queen Esther was the queen in the kingdom of Persia at that particular time, Ahasuerus. She was married to him. But they didn't know that Esther was a Jew, but she was. And it was later discovered that she was a Jew. And Esther's cousin, not uncle. A lot of people will tell you, I've done heard people say, yeah, that's Uncle Mordecai. Mordecai was not Esther's uncle. Mordecai was Esther's cousin. That he raised her, perhaps as an uncle or whatnot, or a father figure. But Mordecai was Esther's cousin, not uncle. But at any rate, Haman was a wicked one that brought up the edict to destroy all the Jews. He was in the kingdom of Persia. Persia is modern day Iran. They were trying to kill all the Jews then, and they are yet trying to do it to this very day. I just thought maybe y'all want to know that before you start passing judgment on the American soldiers for doing our duty. They were doing their job. I want you to know what we are there for. What we are there for. We are going to protect Israel. And I'm hoping that that's our only motive of doing this thing, is to protect Israel. Well, let me tell you what. Iran called us. Iran called America Big Satan. Let me tell you. Let me say it again. Iran called us, the Americans, Big Satan. They call the Jews Little Satan. They hate America and they hate the Jews. Now, let me tell you why. They hate us because we protect and we defend the Jews. That's why they hate us. So they feel if they can get rid of us, Big Satan, they can do what they will with Little Satan. They can go on and get, and they can take out Israel. But let me tell y'all something tonight, my brothers and sisters. It'll never happen. It'll never happen. Believe you me, now they'll try. Because they've already, according to the media, they've already fired rockets at our bases over there in Iraq already. Now they don't mind. They will try. But let me tell you, y'all already know that God is not going to have it. Any nation that ever came against Israel suffered. Because God going to fight for Israel. God always have and always will. Israel will be forever. You cannot snuff them people out. God will fight for them. But let me tell y'all another reason why this thing is going on tonight. I studied in the book of Zechariah, Old Testament. It tells you that all nations will come against Israel in the last days. Now y'all, I don't know. I mean, I can only read what the Bible says. All nations will go against Israel. Now, if it said all nations, God do not lie. Now, we are there tonight, perhaps in defense of the nation of Israel, because we know that they're going to try to strike Israel. We know that. But they have, Iran has went and they britches done got so big until they done fired on us over there now. So now, the smoke got to clear first in a little bit. But let me tell y'all exactly why I said that about all nations. We a nation, right? Last I checked, United States, we are a nation. Bible said all nations going to go against Israel. Y'all, that scares me. That scares me a little bit. Because I would think that we would never go against Israel. But guess what? If you look around with all the anti-Semitic activity that's going on, not only in over the world, we got it right here on our ground. In the nation of the United States, we got anti-Semitic activity and people that hate the Jew. And I know the reason why the Jews are hated. And all of you out there that know anything about the Bible and Scripture, you ought to know why they hate the Israel too. It's because of the fact, because God loved them, the devil hate them. Same way the devil hate you and me. That's what's the matter when all hell break loose on the Christian or anybody that's trying to do what's right. when you try to do what is right, there's always going to be a satanic person. They're going to go against you. They're going to go against you. And like I said, here it is. It's just a week until 2020. Just a week. The day is the 7th. A week into 2020. And look, we are just about in a major war. But nevertheless, not only that, look at our churches. Look at our businesses. Look at our groups. You can't get people to act no right nowhere. They cutting the food everywhere. So guess what? We got to pray, people. We got to pray. And I'm not going to sit here and tell y'all that all is well because all is not well. But we know that God is always going to have his way. We can rest assured that. And everything that's going on is going straight according to God's plan. Everything is leading up to Armageddon. And now, people, those of you that don't know anything about, or you may not even heard of Armageddon, please, ma'am, please, sir, get your Bible and start studying. Everything is leading up to Armageddon. Armageddon is going to be fought right there in Israel. Guess what? Look at all the troops. Where are the troops? Where are the troops headed? To the Middle East. This is where civilization started. And that's where it's going to end. To a degree. That's where it's going to end. And all of the soldiers all over the world, they got soldiers somewhere over stationed in the Middle East. Somewhere around that little bit of nation called Israel. Is the Battle of Armageddon going to be fought in the Valley of Jezreel right there in Israel, in North Israel? And they're going to come down to Jerusalem trying to take it over. That's when we supposed to have that blessed hope of Jesus' second term. Jesus' second coming should be at that point. Now, we don't know when this is going to happen. That's how come no man knows the day or the hour. But we do know we're right in the season, y'all. We're right in the season. And this is how come, and I'm going to say this here, and I say it with passion. We ain't got no time for all this nonsense that's going on, especially when we got our troops' lives on the line. We ain't got no sense of them playing that back and forth basketball schoolyard foolishness up there in Washington, D.C. Them Democrats, the Republicans against the Democrats, the Democrats against the all that nonsense, they acting like children. And then it's our soldiers is the one that got to be out there. They are the one that's going to suffer for the nonsense that those up there in Washington can't make up their mind. But now I don't fault. I do not fault. I don't. What's going on right now? You cannot let the Bible tell us in Ecclesiastes, there's a time for everything. There's a time for war and there's a time for peace. See, in other words, there are some things that we ought to be willing to fight for. And see, I'm the type of person like this. When it comes to doing what's right, I don't care who don't like it. I'm going to speak the truth and I don't care if you tell it. I'm not afraid. I'm not that kind of coward. If I'm speaking the truth, I don't care who don't like it. I'm going to speak the truth. And if you a mess maker, you just a mess maker. We need to stop. That's what happened back in Reagan era. Reagan had to do some things. Reagan had to do some things. And all Reagan wanted to do is just tell him to point the way. And he would go and stop it. They got Gaddafi, didn't they, though? All right, every president had his target. Every one of them had his target. They, when you causing trouble, they show me the hand that doing it. In other words, we got people that we allow to do all their little mess. We and you know about it, even in the churches. We got stuff going on in the church that we know ain't right. But we don't have enough backbone to face it and stand up to it. Well, God can't use no coward soldiers. I'm telling all of you. If you're that afraid, you don't need to be. If you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. I think Martin Luther King once said that. If you don't stand for something, you will fall for anything. And when you know something is wrong, and you know it, and you don't do nothing, you just the bad is the one that's doing it. Don't be up there talking about somebody doing something, but you know about it, but you too scared to say about it because you afraid somebody might stop speaking to you. Who cares who don't speak to Minuteman? I don't care if you don't speak to me. When I'm right, I'm going to stand up. Excuse me. When I'm right, I'm going to stand for what's right, regardless of who don't like me. This is what we got to deal with. And like I said, and I'm looking at our troop, the innocent one, the people, not only our troop, but all the rest of the troop that got to do this thing, they got to go, they are up under orders. Those soldiers, male and female, they are in the air tonight, they are on a farm some other night. I'm quite sure they don't want to be there. In fact, I know they don't want to be there. I know they want to be there. But because they're going to defend for what is right, they got their life on the line. I mean, literally, their life is on the line trying to defend for what is right. And here us cowards over here, we won't even speak and tell the truth in the church. We won't even, we too cowardly to just go on and just do what is right. And then we'll let certain people get away with murder because we're too afraid to stand up and face the music. Well, guess what? I ain't scared. I tell it like it is. I tell it just like it is. And this year and this decade ain't going to be no different on Minuteman's Bible study. Minuteman will tell the truth. And now let me say this again to a lot of you. Let me tell you, I am in no way in no competition with nobody. I do what I do. What God have ordained me to do, that's what I'm going to do. What God have put in my care, in my charge, that's what I'm going to do. I'm not worried about Joe Blow over yonder, what they doing with there. That's them. That's their business. What we need to do is learn to mind our own business and let the other fella take care of his. And then we're going to be much better in the long run. I'm just telling you like it is, people. We got to stop all this here flakiness. We are too flaky. We too much of a coward to even stand up to people who are wrong. And we will let this wrong stuff go a long time and won't do nothing about it. Well, you just as bad. When you won't face the music, when you will not just call my child. I don't care nothing about your child. If your child wrong, your child wrong. I don't care nothing about your child. I mean, when they wrong, they just wrong. If Minuteman wrong, Minuteman is just wrong. Don't go along with me when they're in my wrongdoing. This is what's going on right now. And guess what? Our soldiers are there tonight on a foreign soil. They got families back over here or somewhere. They got family. I'm quite sure they don't want to be on that ground either tonight, but they got to be there. They got to be there because why? They are doing duty and under orders. They have to be just where they are. So why can we sit back and try to criticize one soldier that may have to fire up a shot? You can't criticize. At least they are not cowards. Here we sitting in safe and sound, and they got their lives on the line for us, and we won't even stop. We always talk about we're going to do this and we're going to do that. And now we'll stand up to this. No, you won't even do. People talking about I love you and wouldn't give you, like, I'm like TDJ, wouldn't give you a ham sandwich if you were starving to death. Now, we need to stop all that. We need to stop it all because we are a lie and the truth is not in us. And I'm just waiting for the day when everybody will stand up and stop being so wishy-washy and so scared to face the music. When a person is wrong, they are wrong. And you should always go up against wrongness. This is what Esther did. Esther went to the king. She said, if I perish, let me perish. But I'm going to see the king. And she stopped the annihilation of all her people, the Jews, during the kingdom of Persia, which is modern day Iran. They tried it then. They are trying it right now. And believe you me, all of y'all people out there that just keep on bad-mouthing the military or the president or anybody else, let me tell you something. They wouldn't think twice to kill all of us tonight if they could. So, I'm just telling you like it is. I'm tired of all this here wishy-washy stuff and everybody scared to speak out and they're scared to speak the truth. They would kill every one of us tonight if they could. and the Jew will follow, because they don't like the Jews either. But they know that they have to get rid of us first before they can get to the Jew. And that's it. That's it in a nutshell. I didn't mean to give this whole broadcast to this subject matter, but I had to tell y'all the truth. And this don't only go on for that. That's what's going on in the conflict. This goes up for our conflict in our churches. This goes for the conflict is on our in our businesses, in our groups, in our organization. Whenever you got a devil, you better put your foot on his neck. Whatever you got, you got to deal with it, and you got to deal with it right away. Because it's not going to get better. It's only going to get worse. And you can take that to the bank. I thank God for y'all. And like I said, we did not have anyone in the lobby tonight. As far as the Blog Talk Radio, we not had not one in the lobby. And we're going off the air as far as Blog Talk Radio right now. So I'm just going to spend this next minute or so just talking to y'all in the lobby of YouTube. If anybody is in there. And I just wanted to let y'all know that this is time out for wishy-washiness. If you won't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. And if you see evil being done, and you see corruption that being taking place, and you do not stand up to it, you just as bad as the one that's doing it. And that just, I'm just got to tell you like it is. I'm not afraid to face the music when it come to when it come to right and wrong. I told you we were ain't even in just a week into 2020, and I've already been dealing with some major instances and crises in my own personal life. But guess what? I'm gonna deal with them. And like I say, if I have to stand by myself, I'm gonna deal with them. Because I will not go into another brand new decade, and I didn't even do that in 2019. So I know I ain't finna do it in 2020, because I always will stand up to what I thought was right. And if I feel I'm right, I'm going to stand until you knock me down. And even if you knock me down on the way to the ground, I'm going to still be telling you the same thing, the truth. That's all I know to do. I ain't perfect, not by a long shot, no. But I do know right from wrong. And I do know what the Bible say about these times. Esther saved the people, the Jewish people, from annihilation, from that wicked Haman. She saved them because she refused to be silent. She went to the king and she spoiled his plan, told him who it was. This is what we need to do. Stop trying to cover up for your mean-hearted friends, your two-faced cousins, and your backstabbing nephew. Stop trying to cover for these folk and expose them for what they're supposed to be. I ain't saying don't love them, but you cannot cover for people in their wrong, because when you do that, you just as bad as they are. God is not blind, and he ain't deaf and dumb. So in other words, when you stand up, you may have to stand up by yourself, but be like the Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Be like the Hebrew boy. They stood when everybody else bowed. They stood ramrod straight. That's what you're supposed to do when it comes to right and wrong. Don't you be bending over, bowing down, come out to me. So-and-so may not speak to me tomorrow. Who cares who don't speak to me tomorrow? When it comes to right and wrong, y'all better watch. Y'all better wake up. This the decade to wake up. This 2020, this year of vision. Y'all better wake up and start looking and see things for what they really are, and stop letting people kick you in your butt. You better stop doing that. You better become a warrior like David. David ran toward Goliath. He didn't run from him. He ran toward him. And David, Goliath was two or three times his size. David ran toward him. And guess what? That giant went down. See, we are so worried about who ain't going to speak to us and who ain't going to do this. And tell them we'll just sit there and let them do any kind of thing to people, to innocent people that ain't done nothing to them. And you know it. But yet and still, you won't face the issue. People, we better get ready. We better get right. We better get right. That's all I'm going to say about that. Y'all keep praying for our troops. Pray for these troops that are going to be involved in this conflict. If it gets to be major scale, pray for all the troops that are going to be involved. Because all the troops, every one of them, all the military operation that's going on that soil over there, There's nobody over there because they wants to be there. You can bet that. You can bet that. So pray for them, that everybody in question, that we know, the Lord knows, there's going to be some innocent lives, may going to be lost. We know that. But hopefully the casualties will be few. But this got to happen, y'all. And everything is being lined up for Armageddon. That's how come all the soldiers are getting, gathering together in the Middle East. Because that's where the last major battle going to be fought, right there in Israel, from the Valley of Jezreel in North Israel all the way down to Jerusalem. That's the last battle. And Jesus is going to come. But we don't know when. But we do know that's the way it's going to happen, according to the Bible. So with that being said, we just saying, this is me, the man. I'm just saying, I pray God for each and every one of y'all. The one that did try to come into the Bible study, those that stayed, those that came and left, whatever the case may be, we still thank you too. But this here is not going to get no better. We're going to get worse. It's going to get a lot worse before it get better. I'm just trying to prepare y'all. I've been doing that for years. I've been trying to tell you these days were coming. So you're seeing some of them now. It started back in 30 years ago in my era. Desert Shield and Desert Storm. But it's even not escalated as I speak. So with that said, we hope that y'all have a good one. Have a good week. We pray for the truth. Pray for our country. Pray for all the countries that's involved. Pray for the innocent, that all casualties that be in it, it be very, very few. And on that note, we'll say we will see you on the next Bible study on next Tuesday night, Lord willing. Same time, same place. Y'all be blessed and take care.